Welcome to another video. My name is Sanjay Prakash and I am a Microsoft Certified Trainer in Dynamics 365 and Power Platform. In this video, we will see how we can connect Power BI to Dynamics 365 or Dataverse, and we can create reports by using Dataverse database, right? So let us understand how we can connect. First, we have to open Power BI desktop, and in the Power BI desktop we have to click on this Dataverse icon at the top menu, and in the Dataverse you have to use the URL or the domain of your environment. How to get that domain? Go to your Power Apps and just type admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. This will list out all your environments that you are working with currently. Now choose the environment for which you want to connect your Dataverse and copy the domain name. So how to copy the domain name? So here it is displaying the list of environments. Click the environment that you want to connect. You might have multiple environments, right? So my environments means instances. So I want to connect a development, so click on the development and click on settings, and in the settings what we will do, so it's not about clicking setting. You can go to the environment, click on this development, and here we will see the environment URL. Just copy this environment URL and go to your Power BI desktop and put the domain, the full domain. Don't use HTTP or slash or something like that. So just use this and click on import or direct query. If you want to import, then it will import all the data to your Power BI and you can build your model, but I don't want to import any data. I want to create a direct query so that the data source will, data item will be there in the Dataverse, and I want to just query data, right? So click on query data, use direct query and click on OK. Now it will list out all the tables which are part of your Dataverse environment. You can see here, this is displaying my Dataverse environment and all the tables. I want to use, let's say, account and contact. I want two tables, right? So contact and account. I can click on transform data if I want to transform data, otherwise I can load data. Let me load data first because I don't want to any transformation. I don't want any transformation on these tables. So I'm just reading the raw data of account and contact, right? So the two table information will be listed out in the field section of the Power BI desktop at the right side, and I can use this visualization area to use or to display visualization or charts by connecting to my data items, right? So let us wait for the connection to be established with this two table. And you know that in Dataverse this account and contact are interrelated, right? One account might have multiple contacts, and one account can be associated with one primary contact, right? So there is n is to one relationship between account and contact, and also there is 1:n relationship between account and contact, right? So now it is updating, and once it is updated we can check the relationship of these two tables in the relationship area of the Power BI desktop. And so let us wait. Now the data is getting updated, and now I will go to this table area or the relationship area. You can see here in the left side there are three icons. First icon is visualization, second icon is the data item visualization or table that you want to see all the tables information here, and the third one is the relationship, right? So to check the relationship between two table, you have to click this relationship so that it will give you, so Power BI desktop is intelligent that it will automatically identify which tables are interrelated, right? So I can click on this table, the table relationship, to view the relationship. It's still working on, we have to wait for some seconds more. It's because it is connecting to all data model of account and contact, it is taking time. Now it is trying to creating connection in our model, right? So it's not that much difficult because it doesn't require any code. So once it is done, you can see at the right side the fields and the table is updated, right? Now it is working on it. And we can do we can take any visualization from this panel, and we can connect data items to that chart so that it will render for us to create reports. Now you can see on the right side the two tables are available with all their field items, right? Now I can drag and drop some visualizations to connect some data items. Before that, let me go to the chart, go to the table relationship. You can see here there are two relationships, n:1 between contact and account and contact. Also there is 1:n relationship between account and contact, right? Now I can go here and take some visualizations. I am just clicking some visualizations, and I will take another visualization. This is first visualization. Next click on the whiteboard and click on another visualization, let's say pie chart. So I want only two charts, okay, to render. So let me just drag and resize the chart panel. Okay, now here I want to display the accounts and their revenue, right? So I'll click this and go to account and search for account names, and I'll drag the account name in the axis, and I want to show the revenue. So I'll just search revenue. This is the revenue. I can drop in the value section, and it will show me the revenue of the account. So it will display the account information by their revenue in a bar chart, right? And it is rendering now, and it will display the chart after some time. It will take some couple of seconds, right? So this chart is created. Let me just resize this to make it more prominent, right? Now this is the chart which gives all the accounts in the x-axis and y-axis the sum of the revenue, right? Now I can define some more charts here. Let's say I want to define account count by gender, right? So I can just I want to define the contacts by their gender. So I will just use gender. And you can see this gender code name is coming from contact entity, and I can drop here in the details. I want to display gender information and their count, right? So I'll just use full name and drop it in the value, and I will count it. So what it will display? It will display the gender information by their count. You can see here there are some records which has no gender specified, but male gender is giving this much and female gender giving this much, right? And there are some records which are not having any gender code or any male or female specification because the value is blank, right? Like that I can keep adding more information here. Let's say I want to specify a table here, and in this table I want to display account information. So I can connect account name, for example, because both are related. So I can drag account names here, and also I will take another table to display the contact information. So again I will drop another table, and here I want to display the full name of the contact and its email. Okay, so email address I will pick it from contact. So email address 1, drop it here. So now you can see I have created this report to display accounts by their revenue, next contacts by their gender pie chart, and account information and their related contacts. Whenever you click any account, it will display its related contacts, right? Now this is how you can create your Dataverse connection and create a report. Now the next thing is you have to publish this. Click on publish and click on save. Now use your location. Let's say I want to use desktop to store my PBIX file. So let's say I will give account Power BI report. Okay, and save it. Once you save it, it will try to publish your Power BI online environment, right? Power BI online workspace. Every Power BI has workspaces, right? Your own workspace is my workspace, and a developer workspace I have already created. If you go here, you can see in the Power BI, this is my developer workspace I have created. So there is nothing right now. Now I want to upload the Power BI desktop report to this workspace, right? So I can choose this, click on select. Once I will select, the Power BI report is automatically updated in the developer workspace. Now it is success, click on got it, and I want to close it, right? Now I don't need this PBIX file also, and I can go here and choose refresh. Now you can see this account Power BI report is pulled, published, and this data set is also published. Now my duty is I have to, so every data set in Power BI must be scheduled its refresh time, right? Otherwise it will throw error or it will not give real time. So click on this schedule refresh. So click on data source credential and click on edit credential, right? And choose your organization account and click on sign in, right? Now every time you create a Power BI desktop report, you have to reset the organization login so that your data source is updated correctly. Once the data source is updated correctly, you can schedule the refresh. When you want to schedule, you can define here every 15 minutes or every 30 minutes you want to refresh, you can make it and click on apply. So the data set refresh is configured. Now what is the next thing? This is the report I have created. So open this report to double check, and you can also configure this report's refresh timing, right? Because data source refresh and report refresh is different. Data source will pull data, but when you want to refresh your report, you have to configure here, right? Open the report and you will find there is a option here to configure the refreshing concept of the report. So this is the report I have already created in Power BI desktop, and it is loading. So it will take some couple of seconds, we have to wait. Now click on edit. Now it will open in edit screen. Here you will find there is an option called as format. Click on format, and if you go to down, you will see page refresh. Click on and automatically page refresh enable for 5 seconds or 10 seconds, for example. Every 10 seconds it will refresh. Now I can save it. Now report is saved. Now I want to create a dashboard. So go to developer workspace and create a new dashboard. Now I can also use this report. Let me go back. So this is the report. I can click on this and click on the three dots here. Click on pin to dashboard. I want to create a new dashboard. Let's say account Power BI dashboard, right? Now click on pin live. Now this report is now connected or pinned to this account Power BI dashboard, right? Now this is the dashboard. Now it is pinned here. Now you can embed this report in your model driven apps or any other applications also. Now what about refreshing this data? Every 15 minutes it will refresh. If you add any accounts with new revenue or if you add any contact with new gender, this will be refreshed in every 10 seconds. Okay. Now, once it is done, so this video is all about discussing how you can connect the Dataverse using Power BI Desktop and publish it in Power BI Online, right? Now, in my next video, we will see how we can use this Power BI dashboard as an embedded report in any model-driven app, right? So let us wait for the next video. Thank you for your time, and please subscribe if you have not subscribed.